Making a mistake at live streaming does not mean you're a failure. It just means that you've learned something new. The most common mistake I see Mevo users make is underestimating network congestion. And whether you're talking about being outdoors live streaming youth sports or whether you're talking about indoor live streaming where you actually control the network, the underestimation of network congestion is oftentimes the biggest mistake Mevo users make, because setting up an indoor network and then allowing other folks to be on the network you're going to be on while you stream will kill your upload speed, because the router itself is having to handle all of that back and forth network traffic every time someone picks up their device if they're on that router. So I'll tell you how to fix network congestion for both indoor and outdoor with one caveat. Okay, so indoor, you want to have a dedicated router, one that only your stream is going to be on. I've covered this in a couple of other videos you might take the time to go and watch, but just the quick overview is give yourself and yourself only access to the router that you're going to be using to stream. Go ahead and reserve as much of your upload bandwidth as you can from your internet service provider so that you have all that you need to get your stream going out. Now, on the outdoor side, the problem with relying on cellular connections is that every time someone in your audience or in the space you're sharing that is also on the same cell tower you're using, every time they pick up their device and just turn it on, they may just be picking it up to turn it on to record their sweet little Tommy as they come up to bat. But as they pick it up and record, that device is going to ping the tower. And if there's 200 or 500 or 1,000 folks all picking up their device, say at a graduation, that's my personal horror story, trying to stream a high school graduation. And when the names start being called for graduates to come forward, everybody picks up their phone and starts taking pictures or starts taking video. They're not streaming it out. They're just recording it, rightfully so, but they're all hitting the same cell tower, and so that tower has to ping back and forth with 700 or 1,000 folks while I'm trying to send my upload to the same cell tower, and it just crashes. So indoor, own your own router, and you only use it. But outdoor, the fix there is, the solution there is actually make sure you are recording. Recording is the way to fix network congestion if you're relying on a single cell tower, because it's going to have to ping all of those devices that get picked up when the event happens. Recording means you have the ability to go back and upload later. You may lose your stream. You may actually freeze or black out for a few minutes and it come back, or you may lose it altogether. But if you're recording in the background, you'll have a stream to put back up so folks can watch later, even if you lose that stream. The second live streaming mistake I see Mevo users make is camera angles. If you're doing youth sports, level them up. Especially if you're doing multicam, but even if you're not, so many times I see someone go ahead and take that behind the umpire, behind the backstop view, peek it through the fence just like they're supposed to so that you don't have anything in the way of the camera shot, and then it's off level. It's skewed. The horizon looks like it's running downhill. Go ahead and take the time to level it up. Make sure everything is square and give the folks who are watching at home a good level shot so it doesn't look like your kid's running up a mountain when they run to first base or downhill when they're running to third. Leveling up those camera angles is hugely important for the sports live streaming, but it's also important in the indoor setting. If you're going to be streaming a concert, you want it level with the platform. If you're going to be streaming in a church service, you want to be level with the platform and go ahead and bring it up as close as you can to eye level, to the folks you're going to be the focus of your stream. Taking the time to level up your cameras, making sure your camera angles are what they need to be, will solve that streaming mistake that I see so many Mevo users make. The third thing that I see Mevo users do that is a mistake in live streaming is audio. They're going to ignore audio, thinking, well, if I can just get the stream out there, I'll be okay. And while a lot of that is true, ignoring the audio is ignoring at least 50% of what the experience is, probably more like 70% of what the experience is. How many times have you watched a TV show or a YouTube video or anything that is in video form, and while you're watching it, you pick up your phone and do something else because you can hear what's going on. If the audio is good and it's clear, then your attention can be taken to something else for a little while. You come back to what you're watching and everything looks pretty good. If your audio is not clear, if it's poor audio, you don't have that luxury. So making sure your audio is good is a huge fix for a Mevo user's live stream mistake. And the way to fix audio is make sure you bring that microphone close to the ones who will be speaking or to the sound that you are trying to convey over your stream. If you're streaming a baseball or soccer game, I get it. Crowd noise is all you need. You might want to isolate away from some of the voices that might be a little less fit for public consumption. You know those moms I'm talking about, right? You may want to isolate away from the coach-player experience sometimes, so maybe not shoot your audio, your shotgun mic toward the dugout, but to be able to catch just an ambient audio from the crowd as they cheer, as they're enjoying the game, that's a great plus. If you're going to be doing play-by-play, if you're going to be having a voice over the top of your stream, then audio is something you really want to consider, and having a lapel mic or having a USB mic that's right there with you in order to have that good quality audio so that if you have someone who's wanting to pay attention to what's happening in the game you're streaming, they may be at work and can't watch, but they can listen. Having good audio is a great way to fix one of those live streaming mistakes that we see Mevo users make so often. I would love to know what your biggest mistake in trying to stream your stream. Put it in the comments below. And while you're at it, go ahead and hit the like button.